Hello, dear ones. I am from Bangalore. Some people in whom the Kundalini Kriya happens think that their Kundalini itself is Guru. Actually, that is not true. That is false. It is Shakti that comes through Shakti path, and Shakti is different. Kundalini is different. Before discussing all, we should know what a soul wants to do when it is given Shakti path. The Jivatma, which is a limited consciousness, will try to separate itself from all gunas, traits, which are nothing but Prakriti. Imagine a rice ball mixed with a dish of tomatoes, carrots, and all spices. Rice is staple originally without any gunas, but when it is mixed with the dish, the rice loses its original purity and becomes a dish that has all those tastes. The taste of dish, all vegetables and spices are Prakriti without gunas. Imagine the mixed rice with the dish wants to get rid of all its acquired tastes and want to achieve original purity. This is what exactly happens when you get Shakti path from a guru. Your soul wants to become Purusha like the rice. Now let us take the example of a Gyan Yogi. Every main category of yogi has again several other paths based on various type of techniques, methods, practices followed by the gurus. So based on your type of mind, you are naturally connected to a guru who is of your mind type, and he gives you Shakti path. Then your evolution starts. So what happens in all yogic paths is, once that guru gives you Shakti path, he becomes a kind of driving force who drives your evolution from within. This is what happens in all yogic paths, except in the case of involuntary kriyas. If involuntary kriyas have started in you naturally, then obviously it happened due to natural evolution forces in nature. If your Kundalini is invoked due to some Shakti path given by a spiritual guru, then it means natural forces make use of the guru as a medium for your evolution. In both the cases, the involuntary kriyas and the involuntary movements in you basically advance, which means your transformation needs to begin in all aspects of life. But in both cases, the evolution does not happen, even though involuntary kriyas happen. I have seen my own family members and many friends who are like that. Even if their kriyas happen, basically they live their own lives with their stink of traits and karmas, and there will not be any change in personality at all. In fact, when the situation comes, they show all their color of traits. Same thing happened with me too. I came to Sri Guru few years ago. My evolution started happening, but then I left due to my own traits of ego and rajasic gunas. I went on a big time spree in researching about these involuntary kriyas. I went around the world, went to Himalayas, met Naga sadhus, Siddha gurus, Aghoris and many more tantrics. I also met shamans, voodoo practicing people, but none of them could actually explain them and guide me as to what is happening with me. Nobody gave me right answers except saying that it is because of Kundalini, just live with it. Some even talked negatively about it after spending thousands of dollars and wasting a couple of years. I again came to Sri Guru, where I found my joy and spiritual evolution happening again. So out of all my practical experiences, I understand that Guru acts as a driver within you with his own techniques of evolution, and that Guru also belongs to the same path. Your Kundalini is invoked for journeying. I am sure your life must have started journeying after the invoking of your Kundalini. The Guru is meant for churning your consciousness is in this path of Manthan Kundalini Kriya. The invoked Kundalini is serpent, the tiger that needs to be nourished, guided, taken care, shown the directions with required techniques, methods, and all those actually from the driver of this path, the Guru of this path, Shri Guru. For every specific technique and method of yoga, there is a specific Guru in the world. Even in Gyan Yoga, there are various Gurus with several techniques and methods for this specific evolution through involuntary Kriyas. Manthan Kundalini Kriya is the way. Just because you have these initial Kriyas happening in you, it does not mean your Kundalini itself is the Guru. Guru is Him whose consciousness drives your Kriyas by channelizing them and evolving you. So if you have Kundalini Kriyas happening in you, it does not mean Kundalini itself is your Guru. That is a false belief. You can check it out on your own with this belief practically, whether evolution happens in you or not. Hari Om.